All right, thanks, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Gauden, along with the man who has had to stick with me all season long, Charles Davis. And Charles, the anticipation, the hype, the media coverage, all in the rearview mirror now. We can finally get down to playing some football.
Yeah, don't worry about that, partner. I'll ride or die with you anytime. You know that. But here's the best thing about this. Everyone talks about trying to keep things normal as they approach for Super Bowl. There is no such thing as normal. The pageantry, the hype, all of that is more intense than anyone could ever imagine. What you're trying to do is embrace it in one way and make sure it doesn't totally knock you off your game. That's why the night before the big one, teams often switch hotels, try and get those guys that last chance to breathe a little bit before they go out and play.
Here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain on the play and it'll be second down. The rush defense stout on first down. Here's second and 10 from the 20. Mahomes to throw on second down, and the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive.
There we go now. Green 90.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. On target over the middle to Hill. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go and make the tackle right away.
So Newton and the Panthers come up now first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he's not going anywhere to start the night. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Hey,
On second down, here's Newton. And he fends him off. Steps away to his left. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
They certainly thought they had him surrounded and probably thought they were going to get him on the ground. And get the sack, but he was able to elude that. And even though it threw it incomplete downfield, if you're a defensive back, you're loving the pressure that you're seeing from your front.
They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And down he'll go at the 25. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a fourth down.
I can't help it. Every time I see Eric Berry make a play, as we just saw him make a tackle there, I just want to stand up and applaud.
Because he went to Tennessee like you?
Well, that doesn't hurt one bit, but how about the comeback? I mean, he came back from beating cancer and getting back to Pro Bowl level, one of the best players in the game.
And out come the Chiefs now. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Throwing on second down. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DM.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
On 3rd and long, it's Mahomes. Going for the deep ball. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up 4th down.
I think the punter might start to get into a pretty good rhythm here if he keeps getting opportunities. But that's the last thing his team wants to have happen, right? The last thing you want to see is your punter feeling pretty good because he's out there all the time.
Yeah, first quarter only, but they're 0 for 2 on 3rd down conversions to start this thing. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow here on goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory. And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
back-to-back four-yard runs. Now, look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now third and two, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run.
Here we go.
Third and two, Newton. And he's got his target. That's Moore. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A gain of 32 that time. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching him throw it, it seems almost effortless.
Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 42-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
To throw on second down is Newton. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Three catches for him now in this first quarter of the Super Bowl. Carry by Bell, and he'll get a couple here down to the 22.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Another run, this time McCaffrey. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. The first drive this unit had, they punted. This drive, much more polished, just looking crisper, aren't they, moving the ball?
Maybe the first drive was a little bit of a wake-up call. Probably a little bit angry that they had to punt the ball away the first time they had it. Got motivated, got to the sideline, and said, okay, let's not let that happen.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. After the penalty, it's Bell. And he's going to get this one down inside the 15. A good productive run there on first down. He winds up getting 8. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
On second down, it's Bell. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number two. They're on the march, but facing a third down here.
Here we go.
They'll pitch it out to Bell. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, you not got too many attempts shorter than that one. And I don't think this was blocked. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
There we go. Blue 45.
They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
Ready, blue 45.
On second down, here's Mahomes. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Mario Addison in there to bring him down for a loss of seven. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Z. There we go now.
And instead, they want to throw it off play action. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
It certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And he's got some space here. And he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
Newton on first down. Flush to his right. And Cam is still down here. Appears to be shaken up and in some pain after the last play. We'll get an update when we come back to Miami.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney! Leopard! Leopard!
A give to Bell. They'll be brought down at the 21 after a pickup of four.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. But he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. And into the red zone now. And Charles, they told us offense in the red zone was a focus this week in practice.
A huge priority, and the key was to get points. So you know that all the time during the week they talked about executing, taking care of the football, no big mistakes, make sure they put points on the board and come out of it with that.
The full start backs him up five, first and 15.
Patriot!
The give is to Bell. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
They'll look to throw here. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. And Gano's kick is right through. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. So still no touchdowns in the first half, but we do have some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game, because anytime you can get to the red zone and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this one, being able to kick field goals means you're right there, and then you're just looking for that big break to take you over the top.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Here's Mahomes to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Mahomes again here on second and 10. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. And since they still have 10 yards to go, they'll just say, let's roll this over to third down and decline it.
Let's just be honest about it. If you can't get them off the field on third and 10, then something's wrong with your defense anyway. No sense in taking that penalty.
The Chiefs on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 10.
Black 58 rail.
Working from the gun, Mahomes trying to lay one up deep. And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. D'Anthony Thomas, 75 yards. And the Chiefs are in for 6. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. Butker now to kick this one away. Here's Christian McCaffrey to return it. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. They go play action here on first down. This one complete to Devin Funchess. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A really nice gain of 25 yards. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. On first down, it's Newton. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. This is Bell. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Dorian O'Daniel, third-round pick in 2018, made the tackle.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
The Panthers on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. Out of the gun, Newton. Forced out to his left. He may try and run for this. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's 4th.
And partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's 3rd down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the 1st down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. So 1:56 to play in this 1st half. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this. Throwing on 1st down is Mahomes. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Shaq Thompson. Tough to handle on that blitz. He gets him for a loss of 5. Sacks, a growing theme in this 1st half. This is 2nd and long. Play fake there to Hunt. Now Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And all the way down to the 40-yard line.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for 1st and 10.
There we go now.
On 1st and 10, here's Mahomes. And he'll run it over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Give him 30 yards there.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Luke Kuechly combines speed, intelligence, toughness, puts it all together. It makes plays like one we just saw there. He may not be a big-time blitzer, but boy, he knows how to pursue straight ahead and make plays in the run game.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time. 3rd down here. The Chiefs on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here.
Here we go. Green 90.
They'll run it now out of the gun. It's a decent gain on the ground. Call it 6, but it still leaves them with a ways to go on 4th and goal. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get 3 to end the 1st half. From the left hash, a chip shot here. kick by Butker is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? It made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Final play of the first half, barring a penalty, as they come up on first and 10. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. And some room to work. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So the halftime show of the Super Bowl abbreviated, ready to go for the second half. So we've reached halftime here in the 2020 Super Bowl, Super Bowl 54. McCaffrey on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. To throw is Newton. And the Chiefs are going to get him. Justin Houston coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Newton now to throw. And he gets it to Funches complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. They'll run it now out of the gun. He'll get 3 up to midfield.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
From the 50, Newton. Now he's flushed out left. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. 23 yards on the play. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Anthony Hitchens in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Now whistles. Flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early. Here we go. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. They fake the give. Newton. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. And he'll go down at the 28. 12 yards is the pickup there, and that'll bring up a 3rd-and-11 situation.
Go, go.
The Panthers on third down. 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is 3rd and 11. From the gun, here's Newton. And down inside the 15 he goes. They get 14 yards there and a first down. That's it, baby. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. 1st and 10. Quite sure what just happened there, other than we do know that he spiked the football on first down.
Leopard! Leopard!
And what in the world? Not sure if he just heard a whistle there or what, but for some reason he spiked the football. Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And almost intercepted. Would have been a huge pick in the end zone, but as it stands, that brings up 4th.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on 3rd down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. 3rd down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
A dozen plays on that drive that ends with the field goal.
Let's go ahead and break out some of the old chestnuts here, right, partner? Keep the ball in front, rally to it, and make the tackle, right? No big plays given up, no balls over your head. Bend, don't break.
Hold on. Chestnuts?
You like that?
What does that mean, break out? That just because you break chestnuts?
I'm not sure about that, but I'm just going with why they said that. I have no idea.
Ware takes the give from Mahomes, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line.
Brady, blue 45.
Mahomes going to hand it off to Hunt, and it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that's going to lead to a third and 11. It's Mahomes. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That one good for 12 yards into Kansas City first.
And I know you can't really see it, but that play spells frustration with a capital F for the guys on defense. They covered everyone else, end up going to the running back out of the backfield, and he picks up a back-breaking first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Z. Here we go now. Green 90. Left, left.
Now it's Hunt. And some space here. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Second down. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
They'll run. This is Hunt. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
To throw on second down. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Deshaun Hall in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
How about that, partner? His second sack of the game, and that puts him in some pretty good company. 17 guys have had 2 sacks in the previous 52 Super Bowls, but only 3 have had the record number of 3 sacks in this game.
And we've got the list here. If he gets another one and everyone behaves nicely, we might just list those out for him. Back now here on EA Sports. Going to need better protection here. Third and long following the sack from Mahomes and company.
Hunt.
To throw, it's Mahomes. Being chased out left. And the pressure gets to him again. Deshaun Hall bringing the pressure again, and that is his 3rd sack here tonight.
and that's his third sack, and that ties a Super Bowl record. Makes me think of my old college teammate, Reggie White. He had three with the Green Bay Packers in Super Bowl 31. Darnell Dockett of Arizona, Super Bowl 43. And Coney Ealy, three sacks for the Panthers against Denver in Super Bowl 50.
All those sacks, they've only been an official record since Super Bowl 17. I know it's believed that LC Greenwood unofficially had four way back in Super Bowl 10.
We're in the golden high tops as well.
Newton to throw. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Trying to erase that deficit all at once. One big shot. He took it. Unfortunately for him, incomplete.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw again. Newton. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Credit the secondary and credit the defensive game plan. They've been in his hip pocket all game long. They understood coming in that he was a big-time receiver.
The Panthers on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This is third and 10. The shotgun snap for Newton. Oh, I can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get them to fourth down. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
Here's Thomas. Call that a 44-yard punt, five on the return. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. Out now the Chiefs offensive unit ready to do battle again. They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
The tackle made by Deshaun Hall. He has just been completely taken out of this game. We're in the fourth quarter. He's single digits in the rushing department.
And I know we look at him because the numbers do go to his production, but how about the guys blocking for him? They don't just have his number as a ball carrier. They've got the number of the offensive line and the other guys because they're getting to him before he can get started.
On second down, here's Mahomes. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. So Newton and the Panthers come up now first and 10 at their 38. Now following the interception, here's Newton. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey.
Another miss.
Still on his feet.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Cam's going to run the option right. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Give him three on the keeper there, and it is second down.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
On second down, here's Newton. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. 23 yards on the play. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
They'll go again from the three here on second and goal.
Right here, great.
get it to him running left. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Panthers have taken the lead here in the fourth. Gano the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Gano out to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And bulldozing his way through. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pickup there, a 22.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
Here's Mahomes to throw. Drops it underneath to Thomas. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. Mahomes. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. He was looking for Watkins that time, and it's 3rd and short. I want to go back to something you said in the first quarter about winning.
Is it a positive?
It is a positive.
Okay.
About winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. You were right. They've done just that, and look where it's gotten them.
It's part of the formula. When you go on the road, as you mentioned, being an underdog, winning the turnover battle is a big key, and this one's playing out in this one.
Here we go. 3rd and 1. Gut check time on both sides. They'll toss it to Hunt. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Throwing on 1st down is Mahomes. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Give him a couple on the catch. It's 2nd and 8. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Throwing now is Mahomes. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd. And nobody was open downfield there. Looked like a pretty clear throwaway.
Yeah, definitely was that. I'm wondering why there wasn't intentional grounding. I know they're saying there's a receiver there in the area. Those darn quarterbacks, they get away with everything.
Spoken like a true defensive back, Mr. Davis.
Did that come out?
It did.
Okay. 390.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. And going deep for Hill. This is caught by Hill for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 33 yards. And the Chiefs have taken the lead here in the fourth. The extra point splits the uprights, and that will make this a four-point game. Butker now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Eluding the pressure right. Over the middle, complete. It's Stevenson. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And it'll be a second and long. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
The Panthers on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities. 3 for 9. This will be third and 15. Back to throw. Flushed out right. And this one complete right side to Funchess. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
They'll look to throw to the sideline, and he's got it. They say the feet are down. Yes, the line judge says they're in. That'll be a first down. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. He's back to throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they move this all the way down to the 9. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. Back to throw. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave him with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Now it's Newton. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. What a Super Bowl this has been, and the biggest play comes now. It's fourth down. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, I don't think we'll have to look very hard to find our play of the game. That was an absolutely monstrous big play right there. Backs to the wall. The offense has it in the red zone, driving for the winning score. And he says, not on my watch. And that is one happy bunch on the sidelines.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. Remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph.